Welcome back to our channel. Today's video is about UPSC recruitment for 2021. If you want to read about the recruitment details, you can check the link which is provided in the description. Alternatively, you can also head over to Freshers Now website, which will give you all of the information at one place itself. And don't forget to join us to Telegram, because you will get regular job updates. So Telegram channel is Freshers Now. You can click on the link which is provided in the description box and join us directly. Union Public Service Commission has opened its vacancies for various departments. Official notification will give us all that information. So the vacancies are for the post of Data Processing Assistant in the Directorate Plant Protection, Quarantine and Storage. And the age limit given is for 30 years. The essential education qualification is you should have a master's degree in computer application or information technology from a recognized university. Or you can also have a BE or a BTech from a recognized university as well. And next post is for the private secretary in the Commission for Agriculture, Cost and Price. For this, the pay scale given is 7 CPC. The age limit is 30 years. Education requirement is a bachelor's degree from a recognized university, and also dictation for 10 minutes, 100 words per minute, and transcription 40 minutes English, 55 minutes for Hindi, only on computer. Make sure the qualifications are being taken onto eligibility criteria from the candidate perspective. And next vacancy is for a senior grade of Indian Information Service. For this, we have various number of languages and vacancies which are reserved: Hindi, English, Telugu, Marathi, Bengali and Tamil and Kashmiri. The vacancies are reserved for 1 to 6 in respective languages. The essential education qualification is degree from a recognized institute, diploma or post-grad, or diploma in journalism or mass communications. And candidates must have studied concerned Indian language, one Indian language up to your 10th standard. And these indicates in the same in the online application as well. So according to the preference, you can select up. The experience is required for 2 years of as being a journalist or publicity or in any of the public relation work is also taken into consideration, but you should have 2 years of relevant experience. The general instructions or the points to remember are: candidates can opt for any language under this recruitment, and the choice is given to the candidate itself. And make sure that whatever you are mentioning in the online application form, you should make sure you are following the same in all of the stages of the recruitment process. And documents should be your original documents for document verification. When you are scanning and uploading in the online with the online application form, make sure it is clean and legible. It should include your 10th standard marks, your 12th, all of your relevant mark sheets, your provisionals, your semester certificates, everything, and your ID proofs as well. The next one is for junior time sale, and for this post, 35 years is the age limit. You should have degree or a diploma in social work or labor welfare or industrial relations from a recognized university. The desirable will be if you have done your degree in law from a recognized university, then preference will be given to those candidates. You have 5 vacancies for the post of youth officer in national service. And for this, age limit is 30. Qualification is a master's degree from any recognized university. And experience required is 2 years relating to any youth work or youth welfare, which also includes in National Cadet Corps also, is also considered. But you should have 2 years of relevant youth service experience. The important dates you have to remember is: the closing date for the submission is on 28th of October, and the last date for the printing of the online application form is given till 29th, just one day to print your online application form. So print your documents and your application form and keep it ready. Next is for PWD candidates. Candidates are requested only to apply online and visit the official website as given here. Note that you have to process only through the official website and no other websites. So process only through the official website to get clarity and also the instructions. Age limit is given. Upper age limit relaxation is 5 years for SCST, 3 years for OBC, and vacancies are reserved for the PWD candidates as well. And next, the benefit of the community. Make sure you are submitting relevant reservation certificates, only then you will be getting the relaxations. PW candidates, as indicated, against the various vacancy details, you can apply for the respective post, and the relevant 40% disability only or above is going to be considered. And also you should have relevant document as well. The headquarters or the place of posting is going to be anywhere in India. Probation period as per the norms of the organization is going to be done. So heading over to the additional or the eligibility information, citizenship must be citizen of India, Nepal, Bhutan, or any refugee, or anyone who has been migrated from Pakistan or any other place, but you should have nationality certificate from Government of India. Age limits are given. I've mentioned essential qualifications. I've mentioned already for each post. And next is the important details. You are AWS. You should be having 50% of marks. OBC 45 qualifying. SC STPWD it is 40. You should be having the category wise minimum level of suitability in the interviews in the respective fields and branches. In case where the selection is made by the recruitment, which will be followed by the interview, you should have the minimum qualifying stage. The application phase is going to be 25. You can pay SBI branch or using net banking also you can do your application fees payment. And however, SC STPWD candidates need not pay any sort of application fees. Fees once paid will not be refunded, and they will make sure whichever category you're belonging to put the relevant certificate so that you need not pay the application fees. Upper age limit details we have discussed. And in order to be qualifying for the categories which I have mentioned, make sure you are fulfilling the eligibility criteria. The period of service in the different forces are going to be in Directorate Personnel Service, headquarters in New Delhi. Then you have naval headquarters, air headquarters, navy and air headquarters, and naval headquarters records in Bombay, then Air Force records in New Delhi. So all of this is going to be the headquarters which you can opt up to. The relaxations I've mentioned according to the government directives, it's going to be, and relaxations also I've mentioned for the PW candidates. Now next is the important part where you have to know the application process. So if you're willing to apply, visit the official website, read the instructions, and then you have to make sure you're filling all of the columns or blanks which are given. If you leave anything empty, then the application will be rejected and it will not be taken into consideration. Also, when you are applying, make sure you are putting up all of the documents in a given format. Don't miss any document. So if you miss any of your education documents or any of your caste certificate or anything like that, your application will not be taken into consideration. So also follow the guidelines. You should not exceed 1 MB for your photographs or anything like that. Put it into a PDF format. And so once if you keep uploading, you will be getting all of the relevant procedures. And lastly, if you have to pay the fees, application fees, you can start paying. Candidates are advised to fill all the correct information, especially your email and mobile number. For further confirmations, it will be useful. And when you're giving birth dates or when you're writing your name, make sure you are giving correct spelling and also the numbers also properly. Then candidates need not submit any of your applications to the organization. You should just do the online application form and make sure you're printing out that online application form and also fees receipt as well. Put it with the other original documents, and when you are called for the interview or the final stage of selection, you can take them up. Then you should make sure the recruitment also, don't wait till the last date. As it is already begun, you can start making the applications if you are willing to apply. Also have this attested copies as well. And the last is this commission for the examination or the selections will be held by central government or any other employment under them. Documents or certificates to be produced at the time of the interview, as I've mentioned, those documents should be original or original certificate as summoned. And the next is the general instructions which you have to know. So if you want to read the details on your own, if you want to know about this notification on your own, you can check the link from the description box. So if there's any conversing or duplication, candidates will be rejected. All of this is general instructions for the candidates itself, so you can check this out. If you have any other queries, you can put them in the comment section. And also timely check the official website for all of the updates. Subscribe and thank you for watching.